By contrast, Portsmouth haven't won since Christmas. They include two men who are on loan to them, Ivan Golak from Southampton and Kevin O'Callaghan from Ipswich. And struggling for goals in recent matches, they give a first chance to Dave Bamba, who was signed from Walsall in November. And there's a familiar face in the number four shirt, the former England captain, Jerry Francis. Alan Ball giving him a chance to rescue a career so impeded by injuries. Teams are divided by just 3 points. Just behind the promotion quartet, Barnsley in seventh place. 10 points behind that quartet, Portsmouth in fifth place. Obviously 7 points behind. Ivan Golak. The first touch where he didn't really make it from Bamba, marked by Butcher. And here's the other Butcher, Ron, who is just the older of the two twins. He arrived in this world just ahead of his brother Paul. Early touch for the goalkeeper. Not wanting to get a feel of the ball. That's Billy Gilbert. And Ian Gilbert persuades him it would be a good idea to get a feel of what is obviously a brown ball on a snowy pitch. That's warmed up the referee from Billy Rodson. A sharp to hold, which he does. Golak, just a bit too much pace as it landed, which fooled Scott McGarvey. The referee, who's already made an imprint, which he knew nothing about, is Mr. Ken Redfern. In fact, he's the director of Whitley Bay Football Club. Wild and Gilbert having already a physical contest. Quick turn too by Gilbert. Callaghan. McGarvey. Beautifully played. Sudden change in pace, took him past Joyce. And the goalkeeper at full stretch, Golak! Really a player of his experience. Should have taken rather more time. He had more time, but he flashed at the ball after Baker had rather struggled. But it was a good piece of play by the Ipswich player here on loan to Portsmouth, Kevin O'Callaghan. No flurries blowing around the ground. And here's McGarvey. Oh dear, what an opportunity wasted. But absolutely clear as the ball flicked off Goodison. Failed to make Baker make a save. Thomas, Campbell, good pace. Gilbert across, timed it to perfection. Wild. Forwards having moments at least when they're getting the better of defenders. Laws cross, leg away, Knight looking very unhappy. Law took his time. Less than that for Golak. Oh, and a fine save by Knight from Campbell. Suddenly there was a gap there, and Campbell hit that very hard indeed. And Knight covered to his right on his right hand post. First save of the match, and the match is certainly improving. Struggling there, Wild, blocked on the line by Golak. Law's shot. Coming forward with O'Callaghan just behind those three on the left side. Gilbert. Joe Joyce, the skipper. for a long one. Checking where the hoarding is from that side. Come to be out under no pressure at all by Quinn Thomas. Now in. Butcher. Stab at it by Hardiman, which had to be very carefully watched. And quite clearly from that expression, it was just one of those things which didn't have any real intent. About a corner. Oh, and it's gone in, a combination of two players on the near post, Butcher and Law. And I think it will go down as an own goal. Certainly a very untidy one. Portsmouth have the lead. As we move into the last minute of the first half. Hardiman, who started all the pressure with the up and under, which got the corner. Bamber underneath it again. Callahan. Clear the roof. The referee has the first check of the watch. Corner won by Owen. Just about the time to take it. Well outside the 6-yard box, three inside it. One by Bamba. Owen once more can change the angle. On by Law. Suddenly there was Blake. And an untidy goal, but they all count. One goal divides the teams in Portsmouth's favour. Bamber was the Portsmouth player involved, but it seemed to me that Paul Futcher and Ian Law on the near post made a nonsense of it between the two of them. Half-time score, whoever actually put the ball in, is 1-0 to Portsmouth. Barnsley, very much a go-ahead club. The stand that we're looking at, specially designed for disabled people. It can hold 53 and also 12 people who are cyclists and who are given sound commentary from hospital radio. So away go Barnsley trying to repair the damage, attacking the goal to our right. Predictably, Dave Bamba is claiming the goal. And having claimed it, that will be his first for Portsmouth in the senior team. Scored for the reserves in the week. Bundled straight into Butcher. Owen. O'Callaghan pinched it well. Francis. McGarvey. Bamber is in the middle. Hilaire! Well, he just couldn't keep it down. Coming up very high, and he just couldn't get sufficiently over the top of the ball. Quite a nice attack on the left side. certainly not a good one. Second half gone. Apart from one break by Portsmouth, it's been nearly all pressure from Barnsley, and Winston Campbell capitalises on that pressure to make it one apiece. Really finely driven shot, hardly came up off the snow, and beat the despairing right hand of Alan Knight. Deserved on the pressure, and it's got the crowd a little warmer. Chase by Owen. And he really had no chance of doing any more than that, but he's got his corner. Puts him up on the far edge of the six-yard area. Two attempts, but he was following it all the way through. And his third goal of the current campaign. On by Bamba. Ronson for the trip on Mugabe. Bamber and Butcher. Thomas, Wild. Gilbert again. Timing his movement to great effect. Portsmouth to make the substitution, and Vince Hilaire is the player replaced. In his place, Mick Tate. There's a substitute for the second week running. Too strong, I think, for Owen. He was offside anyway. Ball hanging a bit. Ron Butcher. Twice, they play Manchester City here, they play Birmingham here. Callahan with footwork. Golak. Bamba. Really need his height forward. He gets it across, nobody there. Hardiman. And a couple of injuries. Golak. Some pretty cold nerve endings from the home supporters. O'Callaghan. Blake off the crossbar. Blake again. Yes. Two apiece. And what they did in the first half, they've done in the second. Portsmouth goal beating the referee's whistle. And the points now surely are divided. Blake's second of the season, the ball coming back from his head, off the crossbar, in with his right foot. Well, it will be interesting to see how much longer the referee adds on. Campbell. Barnsley throw. And an offside flag. For Barnsley, but Noel Blake had other ideas, scoring in the final seconds of the time that the referee had allowed for stoppages. So two teams who have hopes of being involved in the promotion battle have to settle for a share of the spoils on a bitterly cold, snowy afternoon.
A lot of energy and